Hello everyone, this is Wagadaro now taking you through today's tutorial on the principle of conservation of momentum. So the principle of conservation of momentum, linear momentum, states that when two bodies collide, total momentum just before collision is equal to total momentum just after collision, provided there is no external force acting, i.e. total momentum just before collision will be equal to total momentum just after collision. So we can also use Newton's laws to derive the principle of linear momentum. So consider two bodies A and B of masses M1 and M2 moving in the same direction with velocities U1 and U2 respectively before collision. So these are the velocities before collision. So after collision, let their velocities be V1 and V2 still to the right as shown in the figure below respectively. So this is the diagram for before collision. They are initially moving independently, U1, U2. Then during collision, there will be a force. Remember, there is action and reaction force are equal and opposite. So there will be equal and opposite forces here, action and reaction. That is during collision. Then after collision, they will move independently still with different velocities. Now, initially it was U1 and U2. Now it is V1 and V2. So the velocities will change. From Newton's second law, the force exerted by A on 2B, it will be FA, will be given by the change in momentum over the time taken. Similarly, the force exerted by B on 2A will be given by the change in momentum over the time taken. So this T is the time taken during collision. And from Newton's third law, action and reaction are equal and opposite. So these forces will be equal and opposite. Remember, the change in direction is noted by a change in sign. So if this is positive, this will be negative. That's what we have done here, positive and negative. So substitute your FA, which is this here, and substitute your FB, which is this here. Other that you can cross, this T can now cancel. I think you can see TT to cancel, so that you come up with that. Other that you will now rearrange, put the initial velocities on one side and the final velocities on the other side. You come up with this formula. Now this M1 U1 plus M2 U2 denotes the initial total momentum, whereas M1 V1 plus M2 V2 denotes the final total momentum. So initial total momentum before collision, final total momentum after collision. So in that way, momentum is conserved. So that is how Newton's laws can be used to derive the principle of conservation of momentum. Now, this principle can also be used to explain some observations. And one of the observations is why a gun jerks backwards when a bullet is fired from it. So this is the gun. A bullet is fired. This gun will jerk backward. And Newton's and the principle of conservation of linear momentum can help us to explain that. So when a bullet is fired from a gun, equal and opposite forces are exerted on the bullet and the gun during the time the bullet is passing down the barrel. The bullet and the gun will thus acquire equal and opposite momentum. Consequently, as the bullet moves forward, the gun moves backward or recoils. So this explains why the gun jerks backward, because momentum before has to be equal to momentum after. So this forward momentum will be equal to the backward momentum. The principle can also be used to explain how rocket is kept in motion. So this is a picture of a rocket in motion. There will be exhaust gas in motion, and also a thrust, and also the weight. So the fuel is burnt in the combustion chamber, and exhaust gases are expelled at high velocities. So these are the exhaust gases expelled at high velocities. This leads to a large bulge. backward momentum or force. And from the conservation of linear momentum, or Newton's third law, an equal forward momentum or force is gained by the rocket. So, because of this, there will be a thrust and equal forward momentum gained by the rocket. Due to continuous combustion of the fuel, there is a change in forward momentum or force, which leads to the thrust, hence maintaining the motion of the rocket. So that brings us to the end of today's lesson. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, Roa e-Learning Platform. I remain Ronald Walkeda. Thank you.